where during lunchtime, our motto was that nothing should be taken seriously what is said during these discourses. And I don't know whether Raj remembers it. I very fondly remember many of the things which were said there. I have had the privilege of the warm hospitality of the Prabhupada family for many years, a few decades now. And I have very pleasant and fond memories of those. Not taking too much of your time, I think Dr. Prabhupada belongs to the category of people who are like the spirit which becomes costlier and more worthwhile when it grows older. Raj, keep walking. My best wishes to you, to your family, and all those that you love for a very happy and long life and contribution to science, to society, to continue with the efforts that you have made. It's a great pleasure to be able to do that in this very impressive gathering.
Thank you, sir, for sharing your thoughts. May I now request Dr. Trilochan Mahapatra to share his experiences.
Respected Professor Swaminathan, Dr. Chopra, Dr. Purodha, other dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. At the outset, let me wish a very happy birthday to Professor Arish Purodha. I consider privileged to be here in this August gathering to express a few words and my own experiences. For me, Dr. Purodha is a personality that needs to be emulated by the youngsters of today. An exemplary personality in the arena of agriculture in this country. The documentary has already described many facets that Dr. Purodha so eminently represent. And this country has immensely benefited out of all that he has spearheaded. When I was a student, Dr. Purodha was Deputy Director General of Crop Science, and I needed a few months of extension to submit the thesis. Professor Chopra was away. Dr. B.C. Joshi was my chairman, and he said, "You go and meet Dr. Purodha." And in the corridor, I met him. I requested him, "Sir, I need a few months of extension to complete my thesis writing and submit it and before joining." He may not remember because there are many students who used to come those days to him. So he said, "With whom you are working?" I said, "I was with Professor Chopra, but he has gone on a few assignment. I'm currently with Dr. B.C. Joshi." And he described why I need. He said, "Okay, you go." And that was done. That was the first interaction, direct interaction of mine, and I'm a beneficiary of your benevolence. And express my sincere gratitude for that. And when we were planning to have a program on genomics, this country never knew how to really do genomics research. We used to teach theory in the classes. That was 1998-99. And it was Dr. Purodha's leadership that, in fact, helped us, helped this country to be in the genomic research map of the world. And the credit goes to Dr. Haresh Purodha. That was invitation from Japan that to join this international consortium for sequencing rice genome. And none of us knew how to really do it. I prepared a project to sequence chromosome 8 of rice that was presented before several stalwarts. And ultimately, it was decided by Dr. Purodha that we have to join hands with DBT, Dr. Manju Sharma and Dr. Purodha, together, planned it out, and that became the first success story of genomic research in this country, the whole genome sequencing program. And in 2000, I was to go to US to do the spade work, to initiate this program, to do physical mapping and sequencing. And I became senior scientist in 99. And the official procedure restricted my visit to the US because of probation clearance that required 2 years. And that was the second occasion when I entered his room. He was DG that time. I said, "Sir, this is the problem." He said, "How long you have been working?" I said, "Almost 10 years. And why this provision should apply to you?" He called the concerned person. I said that if you have to succeed in this project, his visit is so essential, and he should be allowed to go. And that is how I went to US, did physical mapping, and brought those artificial chromosome clones to be sequenced. And that is how India could complete the work in time. And that is the kind of vision that Dr. Purodha has and continues to have. And this is not just to help a person, but on a broader context, move science beyond frontiers. Having that vision to first of all think about it and plan it out so that this is implemented. And with the same zeal, he continues even today. On this 75th birthday, he in fact chaired the implementation of the recommendations of the first International Agrobiodiversity Congress. This is what we have to learn from you, sir, through tasks and milestones for all of us. And every forum I keep telling that you keep providing guidance and leadership, and you inspire whole new generation of scientists through your own acts. And we are so immensely grateful to you, sir. Instead of giving a long lecture, from the Indian Council of Agriculture Research and this position that you eminently occupied, and so elaborately you contributed, and I express my sincere gratitude from the Council for all that you have contributed to strengthen the National Agriculture Research System, and also bringing in new programs that the benefit of which we are harvesting today. So from the Council, from the Department of Agriculture Research and Education, I express my sincere gratitude to you on this occasion. Thank you for all that you have done. Thank you and your family, because the kind of sacrifice family does, I think that is unparalleled. And particularly the cases like yours, when you stand tall and continue contributing even today, certainly the family gets neglected. So from the Council, I also express my sincere gratitude and the gratitude of the council to your family and everyone present here for the sacrifice that they have made to make you what you are and to make the agriculture research system what it is today because of your eminent contribution. I once again wish you a very happy birthday and pray before the Almighty that He gives you strength, good health, so that you continue inspiring us, the whole new generation of scientists in this country, get inspired and continue serving the farming community. Thank you very much. Thanks to all of you for being here in large number.
Thank you, Dr. Mahapatra, for sharing your feelings. May I now request Dr. A.K. Srivastav to put in his thoughts.
Respected Dr. Swaminathan, respected Dr. Chopra, most respected Dr. R.S. Parodaji and his family, friends, at the outset, I, on my behalf, on behalf of whole North system, more particularly from ASRB, convey our best wishes, heartiest congratulations to Dr. Paroda and his family today on his 75th birthday. Let us wish him all the best. And I pray Almighty that in this hall, let us celebrate his 100th birthday after 25 years, sir. So I wish all the best, sir. Sir, I deem it to be a rare honor to share some of my memorable moments which I spent with Dr. R.S. Parodha. In fact, to meet and work with a charismatic personality like Dr. R.S. Parodha has not been a mere coincidence, but a lifetime experience for me. I, being a part of National Agriculture Research System, and more particularly, when I was Director and Vice Chancellor of National Dairy Research Institute, Karnal, I had several occasions to interact him with close. He is not only a doyen of the knowledge in agricultural science and astute research administrator, but also an equally accomplished human being. When Dr. Parodha became chairman of the Haryana Kisan Ayog, he convened first meeting of Ayog for development of livestock in Haryana at NDRI Karnal. And at that time, it was my first occasion that I had very close opportunity to understand his vision on livestock sector. As chairman, Haryana Kisan Ayog, he took a number of initiatives for the benefit of the farmers of Haryana for strengthening their activities, such as he formed farmers club and developing them as a knowledge center. In TAS, which is being headed by Dr. Parodha, and where I also have an opportunity to be a trustee, I always learned from him. He always emphasized all burning issues of agricultural system. What I found that he is having solution of every problem. I found him that he's great motivator for youngsters. He also gave me an opportunity when I presented a paper under umbrella of APARI in Islamabad, which was organized under his leadership. I remember that the organization of 12th Agricultural Science Congress, which was organized at NDRI Karnal in February 2015, was a Herculean task, which could not be managed without his able guidance and his leadership. He also mentored ICR-NDRI wholeheartedly through his innovative ideas and much valued counseling through his active guidance in many of its important events at NDRI Karnal. I always remember, sir, each and every event which was attended and which was chaired by you at NDRI Karnal. I was so much inspired by his personality and knowledge that my very first meeting with him made me to follow his work and way of working very closely. He has immensely contributed to the development and strengthening of the national agriculture research system in India, as has been spoken by everyone. The monumental infrastructure where we are today standing, that we call as NASS complex, would be cherished and remembered for several decades to come. Several awards and distinguished enumerated by everyone, like Rafi Ahmed Kidwai Award, ICR Team Research Award, FICCI Award, Om Prakash Bhasin Award, BP Bal Memorial Award, Borlaug Award, many awards, many prestigious awards, and most prestigious Padam Bhushan Award. To Dr. R.S. Parauda, I speak volume about his passion, zeal, and his laudable contribution to Indian agriculture. He is great visionary. I found him dwelling at length about the future agricultural challenges that people of India and across the globe are likely to face in coming decades. I feel very honored to say that in recognition of his immense contribution and expertise, NDRI has also conferred him a Dr. Sundaresan Memorial Oration Award on 10th February 2012. And I still remember, sir, that on that occasion, you sensitized the NDRI faculty and the students on emerging challenges on Indian agriculture and more particularly livestock sector. The equanimity and exuberance with which he is working and contributing to the growth and development of Indian agriculture is exemplary and worth emulating. I wish him and his family many more years of continued success and active service to the Indian nation. Once again, friends, on behalf of each and everyone, let us wish him all the best on his 75th birthday. Thank you very much, sir, and wish you all the best. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Srivastava, for sharing your thoughts. May I now request Dr. J.S. Sandhu to share his feelings.
On the dais. आज सबसे महत्वपूर्ण जो विषय जहाँ डॉक्टर प्रोदा साहब महसूस कर रहे होंगे कि चार डीजी चार सेक्रेटरी डेयर आज स्टेज पर हैं उनके बीच में उनका 75वां दिन जन्मदिवस जो मनाया जा रहा है. आई थिंक दिस इज अ ग्रेट ओकेजन फॉर हिम. उनकी सारी फैमिली यहाँ पर है और उनको भी बधाई इस दिन की और ये दिन बार बार आता रहे और स्वस्थ आगे यापन हो. आज का दिन डॉक्टर साहब अगर आप मैं सही अंदाज लाता हूँ तो 5:30 बजे आप जगे होंगे क्योंकि सुबह कॉन्फ्रेंस थी उसमें थे और शाम तक अभी दो आज कॉन्फ्रेंस आपने की और पूरे दिन के बावजूद आप भी जिस चेहरे पर जो चमक दिख रही है वो आपका जो स्वास्थ्य है आपका सब कुछ दिख रहा है वो अपने आप में एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है. और एक गांव से जर्नी शुरू करना गांव में पैदा होके और देश की एग्रीकल्चर को गाइड करना ये अपने आप में एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण विषय है जिस पर प्रोदा साहब खड़े उतरे और इनके जीवन में बहुत सारे मोड़ आए होंगे महत्वपूर्ण जो मैं कुछ विजुलाइज कर पाया. एक तो ये 1968 में आपने पीएचडी डिग्री कंप्लीट किया उस समय इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर ट्रांसफॉर्म हो रही थी. दूसरा महत्वपूर्ण आपको जो कॉमनवेल्थ फेलोशिप यूके जाने का मौका मिला वो अपने आप में जो इंस्पायरिंग वो हम कहते हैं उसके आगे बढ़ता है. बाकी एजुकेशन आपका बहुत ठीक राजस्थान से हुआ प्रिलिमिनरी और सेकेंडरी बोर्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन अजमेर में है. मैं भी उसी का ही मैंने 10वीं वहीं से की है. उसका अपना आप एक नाम है उस बोर्ड का और आप वहाँ से नीचे से बिलोंग करते हैं तो हमें भी मान है कि अजमेर से आप आते हैं. और इसी तरह आपके करियर में मुझे लगता है कि NBPGR जो पोजीशन में एक आपका टर्निंग पॉइंट मैं मानता हूँ. यहाँ से आपने पीछे देखकर नहीं देखा है आप आगे ही बढ़ते रहे और इस देश को पूरा आगे तक गाइड करके और जिस सिचुएशन में आप पहुँचे हैं. और आप इंस्टीट्यूशनल बिल्डर्स तो है ही हैं, आईसीआर के कितने इंस्टीट्यूट 30 तो बनाए हैं, और जिस हॉल में हम बैठे हैं, जिस कॉम्प्लेक्स में बैठे हैं, ये सब आपका विजन है। पर एक बात जो आप कहते हैं आज मैं उसको रिपीट कर देता हूँ, आप DDG क्रॉप साइंस रहे होंगे, डॉक्टर NS रंधावा साहब DG थे, तो आपने कहा कि मेरे पास कोई आइडिया है, इसको मैं करना चाहता हूँ, तो उनका जो जवाब था कि काके पैसा तो मेरे पास है नहीं पर मैं तेरे साथ हूँ। तो आज लगता है कि वो जो मैसेज ये है कि अगर आपको कोई काम करना है तो काम निकालना है, कहाँ से लेके आना है, तो ये सब ये सिर्फ चीज़ें आपकी बताती हैं कि कैसे आपने इंस्टीट्यूशन बिल्डिंग किया है। और अवार्ड और ऑनर्स की बात क्या करूँ, 15 से ज़्यादा आपको ऑनरी DSC डिग्री जो है, और आसो ओया स्टेट यूनिवर्सिटी जैसे आपको DSC का डिग्री दिया है, और ज़्यादा नहीं मैं बोलता हुआ क्योंकि अवार्ड्स के बारे में तो बहुत लंबी लिस्ट है, पर मैं 2-3 महत्वपूर्ण बातें हैं। 2 प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया जो फर्स्ट सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया है, उन्होंने आपको अवार्ड दिए हैं। एक तो पद्म भूषण अवार्ड दिया है, दूसरा जो है बॉरलॉग अवार्ड डॉक्टर APJ अब्दुल कलाम साहब ने दिया है, डॉक्टर के नरेनन ने वो दिया, आपने पद्म भूषण अवार्ड दिया, और इसके अलावा आपने इंटरनेशनल वुमेन कॉन्फ्रेंस कराई, मैडम प्रतिभा पाटिल को आपने कॉन्फ्रेंस में बुलाया, एक डिग्नेटरी जो हमारे इंडिया के सबसे हैं आपकी मीटिंगों में आए, अगर प्राइम मिनिस्टर के करें तो गिनती मुझे लगता है उसी तरह आपने जो प्रेजेंटेशन था उसमें भी देखा है, प्राइम मिनिस्टर AP वाजपेयी साहब, देन सरदार मनमोहन सिंह, देन अभी जो लेटेस्ट हमारे अभी के प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी साहब, जो अभी कॉन्फ्रेंस हुई एग्रो बायोडाइवर्सिटी उसमें उपस्थित थे, और इतने लोगों के साथ आपका जो मेलजोल रहा और देश को गाइड करने में और इनसे इंटरेक्शन करने में आपने एक आपको राह मिली होगी, और डेफिनेटली जो आप इस स्टेज पे इस लेवल के आदमियों से काम बात करते हैं डेफिनेटली आगे बढ़ते हैं। और आपकी बगल में प्रोफेसर MS स्वामीनाथन, डॉक्टर VL चोपड़ा साहब, एक बात मैंने ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग सेशन इंडियन सोसाइटी जेनेटिक्स का किया, प्रोदा साहब उसमें चेयरमैन थे पूरे प्रोग्राम के, और बहुत सारे पुराने कोलीग्स को हमने बुलाया था प्लांट ब्रीडिंग के, और जिस तरह की रिस्पेक्ट डॉक्टर प्रोदा साहब अपने कोलीग से पा रहे थे, गले मिल के, आई थिंक वो मेरे को, मैं उसको वॉच कर रहा था कि ये कैसे मतलब कितना आप अपने कोलीग से जो पुरानों से मिलते हैं किस तरह का लोगों का फीलिंग है, और जो ये सोचते थे कि डॉक्टर खेम सिंह गिल आना चाहिए, डॉक्टर खैरा साहब आए, डॉक्टर अटवाल साहब को नहीं बुला पाए, डॉक्टर राजाराम को नहीं पहुंच पाए, तो जिस तरह से अपने कुलीग में जो इनका प्यार है, कमांड है, आई थिंक वो मुझे बहुत ही अच्छा लगा। और 2010 में मैं ICR में जब आया, इस अप्रैल 24 को एक सीट का मीटिंग था, जो पहले क्लोज से आपके पास बैठने का मौका मिला, और तब से मैं ये जानने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ कि मैं और कैसे कर सकता हूँ। जितना किसी सब्जेक्ट को आप क्रिटिकली सिंसियरिटी से आप काम करते हैं, और जो ये इंटरनेशनल एग्रो बायोडाइवर्सिटी की कॉन्फ्रेंस हुई, बहुत ही नज़दीक से मुझे देखने को मौका मिला, और कॉन्फ्रेंस में जो अरेंजमेंट करते हैं, हर आदमी को वॉच रखना कि वो आदमी पहुंचा है नहीं पहुंचा है, उसको कोई कोई रिसीव कर रहा है कि नहीं कर रहा, ये सब चीज़ें जो है माइन्यूटली से ढंग से मैं देखता हूं, और बहुत ही मुझे अपने आप में लगता है कि ये सब चीज़ें हम सबको लिए सीखने की बातें हैं कि इसको आगे बढ़ाना। बहुत सारी आपने कॉन्फ्रेंसेस ऑर्गेनाइज की, बहुत सारी इंटरनेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट आपने जिनके मेंबर हैं, आप ICRISET के बोर्ड ऑफ ट्रस्टी में रहे हैं, और आपको पीजीआर मैन के नाम से जाना जाता है, इक्री सेट ने तो आपका जो जीन बैंक आपके नाम डेडिकेट किया, एक अपने आप में एक बहुत बहुत बात है। और इसके अलावा एक इंडियन सोसाइटी ऑफ प्लांट जेनेटिक रिसोर्सेज डॉक्टर आर एस प्रोदक यंग साइंटिस्ट अवार्ड अभी हमने शुरू करने जा रहे हैं, कर दिया है। और फिलहाल में एक मैं आज पढ़ रहा था आपके बारे में, तभी थोड़ा कुछ बातें याद आई कि अजमेर में जो एनआरसी स्पाइसेस वाला है उसका ऑडिटोरियम आपके नाम पर डेडिकेट हुआ है। ये सब चीज़ें हमें और बहुत सारी चीज़ें हैं, इंस्पिरेशन आप सब वक्त से हमें बहुत हमारे सबके लिए बड़े मान की बात है कि आज आप 75वां बर्थडे आप मना रहे हैं। बहुत बहुत खुशी, बहुत बहुत बधाई आपको और सारे परिवार को। और जो दिन बार बार आता रहे, एक बात जो आप कहते हैं कि जितनी भी जिंदगी हो वो अच्छी हेल्थ हो उसके साथ गुजारना हो तो तभी उसका मज़ा आता है। मैं सब चीज़ों के और आप सबको धन्यवाद देता हूँ इस मौके पर, मुझे ये मौका मिला अब आपसे बात करने का। धन्यवाद।
धन्यवाद डॉक्टर संधु सर। आपने सही कहा है कि डॉक्टर परोदा के चेहरे की चमक का उनकी उम्र से कोई ताल्लुक नहीं है। एंड आई थिंक वी ऑल नीड एन इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम डॉक्टर परोदा। वन डजंट हैव टू गो टू एनी मेकओवर स्टूडियो टू लुक यंग, बिकॉज सर ऑलवेज वॉक्स एन एक्स्ट्रा माइल फॉर हिज फेलो कलीग्स एंड ही एग्जुबरेट्स प्योरिटी ऑफ हार्ट एंड माइंड। सो इफ यू कैन गेट दैट फ्रॉम सर, आई थिंक वी टू विल डिफाई एज एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम। May I now request Mr. Raju Barwale to please share his experiences.
Mrs. Shashi Paroda ji, Prashant, and members of the distinguished Paroda family, ladies and gentlemen, it is a matter of great honor and privilege for me to be part of the organizing committee and to express gratitude on this auspicious occasion of 75th birthday celebrations of Dr. R.S. Paroda. At the outset, I bring greetings from all of us at Mahiko and the Barwale family. As already has been said, Padma Bhushan Dr. Paroda ji is widely regarded as an institutional builder, winner of many prestigious awards. He has worked tirelessly to contribute to farmers' welfare across the globe, including India. For us at Mahiko and the entire Barwale family, he is a true visionary, and all of us, particularly me, are privileged to have benefited from his leadership, guidance, and unstinted commitment for advancement of science and technology in agriculture. My association with Dr. Paroda ji started in the year 1994, when I made a special trip to Australia to meet him in the first World Cotton Research Conference in Brisbane. I had made this trip to consult with him on the introduction of BT cotton technology in India. That time he was on an assignment with FAO in Bangkok. He was very candid, but at the same time very encouraging for making this introduction of this breakthrough technology for the benefit of Indian cotton farmers. His support and advice during the years of long drawn out regulatory process culminated in introduction of this technology in the year 2002. The results and impact of this technology are well known. Personally, Dr. Paroda, I have seen him as a very warm and considerate family person, and we were fortunate to have him and Shashi ji visit us at our home in Mumbai and our research center in Jalna. I also had opportunity to interact with Prashant when he was studying in US, of all the places, on the New York airport. My father, Dr. P.R. Barwale, held Dr. Paroda in great esteem and valued his foresight and grounded approach to things in life. On this momentous occasion of his 75th birthday, Our prayers to the Almighty are to bless Dr. Paroda ji and the entire Paroda family many more years of healthy, happy and productive life for a selfish reason, so that all of us continue to benefit from his leadership, guidance and unstinted support for introduction of science and technology in agriculture. I am grateful to the organizers.